What are they doing? Join in the madness on today's Rage.
Привет, ребята! Если вы не понимаете то, что я говорил, ничего страшного, не волнуйтесь, вы действительно смотрите Рейза ТВ. Только мы сейчас в баре на крыше Люф, на необыкновенной вечеринке, называется Тет-а-тет, где существует только одно золотое правило. Говорить по-английски нельзя. А что будет дальше? Давай посмотрим. Привет, ребята! Если вы не понимаете то, что я говорил, ничего страшного, не волнуйтесь, вы действительно смотрите Рейза ТВ. Только мы сейчас в баре на крыше Люф, на необыкновенной вечеринке, называется Тет-а-тет, где существует только одно золотое правило. Говорить по-английски нельзя. А что будет дальше? Давай посмотрим.
Not your ordinary social gathering. Tête-à-tête is a monthly event that gives you a chance to practice your language skills. So guests are grouped according to the language they wish to converse in. Armed with just a list of instructions, we set out a series of challenges to our linguophiles to see just how well they can function without English.
Pouvez-vous danser comme un poulet?
Baila el baile del pollo.
¿Puedes como un gallo bailar?
¡Suena un chen!
¡Suena un chen! Fare la chicken dance.
How about trying these lines from a well-known scene off a Britney Spears music video?
Britney, before you go, there's something I want you to have.
Oh, it's beautiful. But wait a minute, isn't this?
Yeah, yes it is.
But I thought the old lady dropped it into the ocean in the end.
Well, baby, I went down and got it for you.
Aw, you shouldn't have.
Brittany, 我有一样东西我想送给你。
Brittany, before the gates, have ich etwas, ich habe etwas, das ich zu dir geben muss.
Oh, es muy bonita.
Oh, c'est génial. Mais attends une petite minute, qu'est-ce que c'est?
Si. Yeah, das ist.
Ma pensavo che la vecchia signora l'avesse fatto cadere nell'oceano alla fine.
我以为那个老女人掉到海里，最后。
Allora baby,
darling, 私は海に行って取り戻した。
Ah, sonna.
Oh, non avresti dovuto.
你太不应该了。
Ever since picking up Spanish in 2009, Tête-à-tête founder Terence Yeo was inspired and felt that language enthusiasts in Singapore could do with more practice outside the classroom.
I realized that for the French, the Italian-speaking people, the German-speaking people, everyone was looking for an opportunity to practice. And so I said, hey, why don't bring everyone together? And then Tête-à-tête was formed. We have about a 30-70% mix, 30% expat, 70% local. And that's very important to us because we want to help the local Singaporeans who are learning the language get better at the language.
The free event currently features 6 languages: German, Spanish, French, Italian, Japanese, and Chinese. Since the first Tête-à-tête in October last year, the event has gained momentum and now draws about 100 people every time.
What are some of the challenges putting together an event like that? Because you have people from with different standards and, like, you know, people from all walks of life. So how's it work?
We have one motto, and that is for everyone to come without the to speak without the fear of making mistakes. But what we've done in the recent events is to split tables into beginners and then intermediate and advanced. And so hopefully that will help to solve the problem. But it remains a challenge because there are usually more people in the beginner and intermediate level than the advanced. But eventually, I guess it will just grow organically to accommodate all of them.
Do you find a lot of people cheating and using a bit of English in there?
Yeah, sometimes they cheat, I guess, when they become saturated with the language. But I guess the point is we're just trying to create an environment for them to use the language, especially in Singapore where everyone speaks English.
Someone told you that, oh, the language really improved since October?
A ton of people, because they don't really have the chance to practice, especially people who have learnt it abroad and now are back in Singapore and are not taking classes. So yeah, I think so. Yeah.
So you're hoping to expand it into a cafe in the future, I'm guessing?
We don't know. It's a flip of the coin, so stay tuned.
So the next time you're tired of English, you know where to go. Want to learn how to pick up someone in 6 different languages? We'll teach you how in our other clip.